The blood cells of cancer survivors hope to help other patients cure. Human trials will be conducted in 2018. Blood cells from cancer patients with strong immune systems can be transmitted to other cancer patients. The scientists hope that this can help all patients recover to complete remission. In fact, some cancer patients have very healthy neutrophils, so they attack and kill cancer cells to help them recover and survive miraculously. Neutrophils are the primary defenses of the immune system. And scientists want to gather the strongest cells from these strongest people, growing them into an army that will help other cancer patients. Neutrophils are multiplied in the laboratory to reach 2.5 billion cells before they are passed on to cancer patients once a week and for 6 weeks in a row. In tests, the cells were able to kill 95% of the cancer cells after 24 hours. Lyft Biosciences, a biotech company in the UK, is currently preparing to test neutrophils on a small number of patients first. "We are not simply talking about keeping cancer under control," says Alex Blythe, managing director of Lyft Biosciences. "We are considering a therapeutic approach in which you will receive a weekly course of treatment lasting 5 to 6 weeks. Based on experiments in the laboratory and in mice, we hope to see patients fully remedied. Our ultimate goal is to create the world's first cell bank, which stores neutrophils capable of killing cancer cells in a powerful way." The work of the research team at Lyft Biosciences is coordinated by scientists from King's College London. Initially, they focused on developing neutropenia to treat pancreatic cancer, one of the most dangerous forms of cancer. Only 4 out of 100 pancreatic cancer patients survived for 5 years. In addition, initial tests show neutrophils can also kill cervical cancer cells. A strength of neutrophil use method introduced by Lyft Biosciences. It is the white blood cells from the donor that can be given to any patient, without worrying about the immune response. This is because neutrophils live only in the patient's body for about 5 days and disappear before the recipient's immune system has the chance to attack them. Neutrophils can directly kill cancer cells, their chemicals and antibodies. Or it could also indirectly help the patient fight the disease by activating other immune cells that also destroy the cancer. There is some evidence that neutropenia sometimes does not identify cancer as a threat to the body, and may even mask the tumor from other immune responses. However, once this type of leukocyte is targeted at cancerous tumors, it destroys it very effectively. In the experiment, the scientists observed that neutrophils destroyed 95% of the cancer cells within 24 hours. This effect has led them to believe that this type of leukemia will become a potential candidate for new cancer treatments. Prior to that, the team at Lyft Biosciences collected thousands of abandoned cells, such as medical waste from blood banks. They examined the ability of cancer cells to kill cancer cells in a laboratory environment. Cells that pass the test impressively will be cultured and multiplied several times by a process that is kept secret by Lyft Biosciences. Researchers are also looking to genetically modify them to make them more powerful cancer killers. Professor Fartzen Fartzen, head of research at King's College London, said, "I had some initial skepticism when Lyft Biosciences questioned us. That's what I did not believe in before. Producing specific cancer-killing cells is a concept we have not thought of yet. We were very excited about these early results." Within a year, the research team at King's College London and Lyft Biosciences will proceed to test their neutrophils in humans. A small group of 20-40 people with pancreatic cancer will be treated first. Another possibility for testing is also available for patients with soft tissue cancer. Each patient will receive a weekly neutropenic transfusion. Treatment will require about 2.5 billion neutrophils for a patient,